All right, today what we're going to be doing is we're going to be planting us some early frosty peas. And with that, we're going to be inoculating them with our leguminosarum bacteria, and that's a rhizobium. And this is the bacteria that fixes the nitrogen into the plant. Not the soil, but it fixes the nitrogen into the plant. Once the plant is done using that nitrogen, we can turn that into the soil, and then other plants can benefit from that. And that is the misconception that a lot of people have when they're planting legumes and thinking that they fix nitrogen into the soil. I've already prepped this soil with my alfalfa pellets, and these early frosted peas, they climb about 36 inches. So all we're gonna do there is just make a trench on one side, come down, and do the same thing here. So what we wanna do is make sure that we get these at least an inch into the soil. We're gonna let them climb up on our trellis, so they should land somewhere up in this area here. Now, I'm gonna show you something here. I've already inoculated these. Look at that. And what that is peat moss along with this inoculant. So what happens is the inoculant attaches itself to the roots of the plant and fixes the nitrogen. So we're just gonna break that up and take these one at a time out. That's your radical right there coming out. That's the first root. And that's your actual plant right here. And we want that radical going down. Put it in to cover it up. Just lightly cover it up because we're gonna water it in. Same thing, look at that one. Just gonna keep putting those all the way down. It's a good one there. Another good root. Get me over here to the other side. I'm gonna just keep doing the same thing. And then what we're gonna do, we're gonna take our bacteria and we're just gonna sprinkle a little bit of it. That's our leguminosarum bacteria. And there are actually 238 species of the rhizobium bacteria. So you have to make sure that you get the correct one that's for the particular plants that you are planting. We're just gonna cover that in. And then from there, we're just gonna throw a little bit of our mulch on top just to keep that from drying out. I'm going to give a big shout out to David Corey with the crop, because David Corey with the crop put me up on these fava beans last year, where you got a lot of people call them petri dish. I call this my petri bed. And this is where I've inoculated this bed on last year. And I continue to take soil from this bed and I've added that soil into this bed. So this bed also has been inoculated with that leguminosarum bacteria. Now this is good for vetch, peas, and also beans. I'm also growing alfalfa, which is a legume, but this is not the same bacteria that you want for the alfalfa. The bacteria that you need for your alfalfa is called melilotti. The way that you know whether or not if your plants are fixing nitrogen, the only way to do it is to pull the plant. We're gonna try not to damage our fava beans here, because these are gonna be for our other beds in case one of the plants don't make it. We can take these and add them back into the bed. So over a million of this rhizobium bacteria to form one root nodule. But what I want to do is just show you that bacteria on there. Oh, there she go. You see those nodules right there? And they're nice and plump on there too. These are our Orient wonders. So they're not gonna make it through this cold. We just had some mid 30 days. So that's the reason why they're looking kind of rough, and you see the difference between the colors and the way the Orient Wonders are doing and the way the fava beans are doing. The fava beans are good down to 15 degrees. It's going to take a few months for those nodules to grow onto these particular plants. What I simply do, split this, put it into some peat moss, put a little water added to it, and that bacteria will continue to spread. So we're just going to stick this back in here for now. And what I'm doing is taking the soil from this bed here, and I'm mixing it in with the soil right around the seeds. And that's how you move that bacteria from one area to the next. We're gonna go down here and we're gonna see if that bacteria has moved over here. So we're gonna just come over and pull this up. So this again is one of our Orient Wonders. Yes, sir. Look at that. That's the leguminosarum bacteria from the Rhizobium family. And again, so we know now, not only does it work on peas, not only does it work on beans, it also works on the Orient Wonders. We're gonna put that back in the soil and just let it run its course. You'll see here where our early frosted peas have come up, and all of these have been inoculated. So now what we're gonna do is just kind of show you how we inoculate our seeds. What we have right here is some peat moss and some unsulfured blackstrap molasses. And what I have in this bottle right here is some distilled water. And I'm just gonna go ahead and saturate this a little bit. Normally I put some hot water onto the peat moss just to get it to absorb the moisture. We're just gonna mix that in. It don't necessarily have to be soaking wet. We just want it really moist. All right, so now what I'm going to do here is I'm going to take some of my molasses, and it does not take a lot. And what the molasses does is basically that sugar or that food that causes those microbes to multiply. You don't need a lot, just a little bit. That's it. And we're just going to mix that molasses in to that peat moss. And this is just how simple it is to inoculate your seeds. I'm not saying that this is the way everybody else does it, but this is how I do it. So what I have here is a pack of my leguminosarum bacteria. I'm going to open this up and you'll see what that looks like. But basically what this is ground up peat moss with the bacteria mixed in it. Tap that down into that peat moss. You want to be real careful on how you move them around, because you can destroy them by mixing them up too rough. As the peas start to root, that bacteria is going to attach itself to the roots. Again, we're going to go back to this and just let you see what it looks like after we mix this stuff in. And that's basically how it looks when I go in here. And you'll see it starts attaching itself. And what we'll do is we'll take this peat moss as well, and we'll mix that into our planting holes as we go, and then that bacteria will continue to spread from bed to bed. Okay, we're going to just drop these on the cap, and then we're going to spray our distilled water on them. We're going to take some more of our leguminosarum bacteria, but the whole thing is you just want that to be a little damp, and we're just trying to get that bacteria to touch all of them. Mix those around. Now you can get a little paper plate or anything like that, but I'm out here in the garden and these are finna go in now, so I just wanted to have something so you can get an idea of just how simple it is to inoculate your seeds. And again, you can do as many as you want. I'm just doing this for the demonstration. And they don't have to be all covered. You want to use distilled water when you're doing this. This is the way that you inoculate your seeds. And that's what you're gonna have in a couple of days. This is not a very difficult task, but once you get that bacteria settled into your soil, that's 78% of the nitrogen that's in the air, now it's gonna start working for you for free, the way nature was meant to be. And we're growing out the box.